Hi, I'm Katharine Eira Brown. I play in a band called RATTLE, and I'm going to talk about five albums that I'm really pleased that I found in a charity shop. So number one is this album here. It's called Gorilla by Ut. I didn't know this band at all. It isn't actually in the full artwork. I found it like this. I found it for £1. Where at that time, before the internet, before you couldn't Google these things, you found a record, you read the sleeve, you would look for things that would mean the secret code to them being like good. I mean, £1 wasn't a big investment, but probably at the time it was. So there was interesting things. It was guitar, bass and drums. There's women, that's interesting. There's a violin appearing here. Scrolling down, it was recorded by Steve Albini. I'd heard of Steve Albini. I knew he'd recorded the band Nirvana. I'd heard a bit of his work. So it was already like, oh, this could be a good investment for me. So I put the record on. It takes you into like this spiraling, amazing world of noisy guitar, frenzied, frantic female vocals, women having an amazing time making music, which was the life that I wanted. I mean, I hope I'm working towards that life. So it was a great album to find, and I was very pleased to find it. Okay, so number two is this album, Solid Gold by Gang of Four. I found this in a charity shop in Sheffield. I was visiting my friend Chris Clark at the time. He had just gone to university there. And we were going to steal some guitars, took the guitars, but on the way, we popped into this charity shop and I found this record. I played a gig recently in a band that played the guitar, and someone at the gig told me that he thought my guitar playing was a mixture of Gang of Four and Captain Beefheart, and neither of those things I'd heard of. And so I have my radar that I wanted to check them out. And then so to find it in a charity shop was very exciting. So again, put on the record, loved the guitar playing, loved the sound of the guitar, loved the excitement, the groove of the music. I suppose it's probably like my first step into discovering post-punk, I suppose. You know, everyone knows Andy Gill's guitar. I don't need to tell you about this record, but it was I enjoyed finding it, I loved playing it, and I was very happy with the that someone had said that about my guitar playing. So number three is this album. It's Big Science by Laurie Anderson, and I loved the cover straight away. I didn't know anything about Laurie Anderson. The words Big Science would probably put me off it, because I really didn't like science, but I really liked the image. I was like, what's going on here? The sunglasses, there's something really interesting. And I turned over and I saw the violin. I thought this looked good. And I looked through the record looking for any kind of clue. Let's give it a go. So got home and put this on, and it was just totally amazing to find an old record and have this music that sounds like it's come from the future, because you can't imagine where else it could have come from, and just has so in a way so little there, but this amazing absence of stuff which just feels like it's full with music, even though it's I love that sort of minimal, but like you can hear all these almost like secret ghost harmonies or something, or go, you put it on and it's like putting on a film. I felt like I put it on and I was in space. I was like just an amazing record that was and with the voice as well, so like a lot of stuff with the voice that was like, whoa. Record number four is this one. It's called Nothing Can Stop Us by Robert Wyatt. It says here, sleeve notes, you may notice some technical inadequacies in some of my performances. A hesitant beat here, a dodgy note there. That was really like, that would have been like, oh, that's interesting. And that's how I feel about music now. I'm in the middle of mixing things at the moment, and you get to this nitpicking part when it's just nonsense, and you're like, you have to be careful to rein it in. So went home and put it on. It wasn't at all the music that I thought it was going to be. Didn't sound like rock and roll or like rough and ready DIY music that I thought it might have been. But absolutely fell in love with it. Just love his use of melody, that really sort of sad but beautiful melodies, the kind of lullaby nature. I think it reminds me of they're being sung to as a child or something from like I love everything about it. He is a drummer, and I imagine there's probably something there about the way that he writes music and thinks about rhythm. And it's actually an album of covers. It's a compilation, and it has Shipbuilding on it, which is interesting because then I was kindly bought this album as a replacement for my old Scuff CD on vinyl, and on this version it doesn't actually have Shipbuilding, so I'm not sure what happened there, why Robert Wyatt had to take it off this album. And I wouldn't have bought this album. Hasn't got the same sleeve, hasn't got the notes, it hasn't got the handwritten stuff, all the things that attracted me to it. I probably wouldn't have bought this if it hadn't had those things. Okay, so there are lots of other albums that I could talk about that I found in charity shops over the years, but I wanted to finish on a more recent one, which actually isn't an album, but it is this record, which is Grace Jones' She's Lost Control 12-inch single, long version. This is her infamous cover of the Joy Division song, She's Lost Control. I found this in a charity shop in Nottingham, which is where I lived until recently, and I found this, I think, just when the shops reopened after all the lockdowns. So probably one of my first times back into the charity shops, and straight went in and was happy that someone had decided to purge this in their lockdown life. When I played in Kogumaza, our sound engineer Mark Spivey would play this song a lot. Before we played gigs, we listened to it in the car on the way to gigs, and it was great to find it and take it home and be able to dance to it in my own house. So that's my final one, and thank you very much.